Hey guys, I'm Haley Randall and I am a competitive powerlifter, a law student, and an all-around busy person who loves to lift. Welcome to my channel where I go through all different kinds of fitness and powerlifting related topics and try things out so that you don't have to. So for those of you who tuned into my video last week, you know that I have been putting some work into my home gym to get it to be a place where I enjoy working out every day. So for those of you who haven't seen that video yet, I'll put the link in the description for this video. Anyways, those of you who know me or follow me on Instagram or whatever, know that I'm a law student and that I work at a legal clinic, and I'm an all-around very busy person. With that being said, I spend the majority of most of my days running around like a chicken with my head cut off. And because of this, I'm usually at any one time lugging around way more shit than any one person should ever actually be lugging around, including my gym bag, smelly gym shoes, workout crap of all different assortments, meals, shaker cups. It just goes on and on and on. Basically, my goal with improving my home gym, is to cut out one of the many, many middlemen in my life. And save myself some time, and also just to reduce the sheer amount of crap that I have to lug around with me every single day. I decided that now that my home gym is a place where I can do pretty much everything that I need to do for my workouts, I would commit to doing all of my workouts at home for a week and then provide you guys with an update on some pros and cons of using a home gym as opposed to a big commercial gym. So the first pro that I noticed about working out in a home gym is one that will likely resonate with anyone who is serious about lifting, and especially with power lifters, and that is freedom. So freedom to do whatever you want when you work out. No one yells at you for slamming the weights down. You can blast your own music. You don't have to listen to Taylor Swift rip off "I'm Too Sexy for My Shirt" 500 times a workout. I swear, every time I'm at the gym, that song plays at least like three or four times. So instead, you can blast the real "I'm Too Sexy for My Shirt" or whatever other music floats your boat. Also, if you live with a normal human being or alone, no one's going to yell at you when you make it rain with the chalk. I had about a million red flags or whatever it's called on my World Gym membership, so it was time to go. Although Derek still yells at me for my excessive and messy chalk use, so I didn't really fully escape that one. So the next major pro about working out at a home gym as opposed to a commercial gym is that you literally never ever have to wait for a machine. So you own that power rack, literally, and you don't have to worry about hogging a machine while others are waiting to use it. So, sometimes, even though I'm doing a perfectly valid workout, when I'm squatting and I'm resting like 7 minutes between each of my heavy sets, and there's people waiting to use the squat rack, it starts to feel a little awkward and you start to feel a little bad for making them wait. So when you're working out at home, neither of those things are an issue. You never have to wait for machines, and you never have to keep people waiting when you're doing your workout. I swear, there have been times when I've literally driven to the gym, gone inside the gym, and actually left because it's squat day, and I've waited half an hour to use a squat rack, and one's still not available. So that's just a huge waste of time. It's a huge time suck. And that's probably my favorite part about working out at home, is when I want to use something, it's there. And I do not even have to wait 2 seconds to use it. So that basically sums up the major tangible pros to working out at home, although there are also some other great aspects to it that are harder to put into words, like the general atmosphere, the comfort level, and the lack of smelly, sweaty people other than yourself. In terms of cons, there are not many, but there are a couple things that I noticed. So the first possible con to working out at home instead of in a big commercial gym is you lose the show-off factor. So, this might not matter to everyone, but I know that there are times when I'm feeling less motivated than usual, when it really helps to have others around watching my big lifts. It can give you that extra little push on days that you're just not feeling totally into it or you're feeling kind of blah. But I guess if you do gain motivation from that, then you can use Instagram in the same way, post your videos on the gram and have people comment on things there. So that was the first con that I noticed. The only other con that I really noticed from using a home gym is that there's some pretty cool people at the gym that I was going to work out at. So I do miss seeing them and watching their progress day by day. There's a social aspect, I think, to working out in a big commercial gym, especially once you get to know the other people who are kind of into the fitness world there. So if you're someone who enjoys the social aspect of going to the gym, you're not really gonna likely enjoy making a complete shift to working out from home and doing it all the time. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please comment below and tell me whether you prefer working out at a home gym, or in a big commercial gym and why. If you like this video, please don't forget to like it and subscribe, and I will see you guys on Sunday. Thank you. Bye.